Hey, hello everyone. In this video, I'll be showing you how to solve warning each child in a list should have a unique key prop in React.js. And even though I'm getting my output perfectly, I'm still getting this warning in my console. So I'll be showing you two ways how you can solve this problem. And I will also be explaining you why you are getting this problem over here. So let's get started. So first, let me explain my code. Okay, I'll just go to Visual Studio Code. And this is my like a really, really simple piece of code I'm having over here. This is my array, and it has like each item has a key, which is text, and a value. This one React is fun to learn, so that's getting displayed over here. And this is my map function, which basically iterates through my entire array with the help of this val. So this val basically corresponds to each item present in my array. And I'm having a div and h1 tag, and this val dot text is this is the key, and it's just displaying my text. So that's why it's appearing bold because of the h1 tag, and I have like a center. Okay, that's why it's appearing in the center of this page. Okay, so now let's find out what is causing this error. Okay, so this is the reason why we are getting the error. Okay, so just read it out. Rows in JS array should have a unique key property, and it helps React.js to find references to the appropriate DOM nodes and update only content inside them and not re-render the entire table or row. Okay, so it basically tells us that every array item, that is each individual item, should have a unique key, which we aren't having over here, because this unique item or a key helps React to identify which particular value in an array or a div tag or a component is getting changed. So this helps React to update or modify only that particular component instead of updating or rendering the whole context. Okay, so that's the main thing. If you want, you can just pass it and read it out. Okay, so this is the reason why we are getting this error. We haven't passed that unique ID or a key. So the first method of solving this problem is, you need to just go here inside this particular val reference that you are having for iterating through each item in the list. You're just going to put a comma, you're just going to put I or any other name, it's up to your choice. And inside the returning tag, so here I am returning div tag, that is, this is the main parent tag, and this h1 is a child tag. Okay, so what you're doing is, inside this div tag, you're just going to put key equal to, within curly bracket, you're just going to put I. This I corresponds to this text. So if you are putting index or any other variable name, you're just going to have the same name over here as well. So now, if I just save it, I'm not getting any error. And if I just go here and refresh it, boom, my warning has vanished now. So this is now working perfectly, all right. So now, what it basically does, because this key is the unique ID that we were referencing over here. This key equal to I is the unique ID that React wants to have in an array, okay? So if you want, I can just also display the value as well. So I'm going here, just put a plus, some space, plus and I. So this plus operator just concatenates a string, okay? So if I now just save it, and now I go to the output, I'll be getting 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this number directly corresponds to the index number of each item in my array, okay? So that is going to be unique, because each item is going to have a unique index number, okay? Because we basically can't have same index number for every item. So it's going to be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's going to be obviously unique. Okay. And another way, that is the second way of solving this problem, is by manually having unique ID in each array item itself. So let's example. So for example, I will just go here and I will put ID colon, I will put 1 comma. Okay. So what I will do is, I'm just assigning a ID to each item in my array. Okay. So just paste it. And I will put 2, and go here, I'll put 3, come over here, and this is supposed to be this. Copy this, paste it, and this is going to be 4, and this is going to be a 5. Okay. That's it. I think we aren't getting any error over here. And fine, and instead of this I, just remove this I, okay? And here in the key, what we will be giving is val dot ID. That's it. Okay, we'll just remove all this stuff. So now, instead of giving index as the unique ID, we are having our own ID over here. But the fact is that you need to give this ID unique, because if you give this ID 1 here, and for the second item as well, if you give 1 as the ID, it will obviously throw you an error. This ID for each item in an array should be unique. So now I don't have that I over here. I'm just passing my ID for each item in an array as a unique ID or a value over here. That's it. If I now save it And as you can see here, refresh it, I'm not getting any error over here. So really simple. I've shown you two ways. One is by using this comma I and key equal to I. And another one is like having unique ID for each item in an array itself. So I hope you would have found this video useful. I also run many other videos in C, C++, Java, Python, SQL queries, as well as 3D animation using Blender. So do check other videos of my channel. Subscribe and support me. Thanks for watching.